فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل، وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين، أما بعد. The 29th قاعدة، القاعدة التاسعة والعشرون، it is أنهم يحذرون من جعل الدين وسيلة للحصول على الدنيا. They warn against أهل السنة والجماعة. They warn against من جعل الدين, anyone who makes the religion, وسيلة, a means, للحصول على الدنيا, to attain the dunya. أهل السنة والجماعة, they warn against the person who tries to use the religion as a means to gain the dunya. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said in the Quran, مَنْ كَانَ يُرِيدُ الْعَاجِلَةَ عَجَّلْنَا لَهُ فِيهَا مَا نَشَاءُ لِمَنْ نُرِيدُ ثُمَّ جَعَلْنَا لَهُ جَهَنَّمَ يَصْلَاهَا مَذْمُومًا مَدْحُورًا. Allah also says subhanahu wa ta'ala, فخلف من بعدهم خلف ورث الكتاب فخلف من بعدهم خلف ورث الكتاب يأخذون عرض هذا الأدنى ويقولون سيغفر لنا وإن يأتيهم عرض مثله يأخذوه ألم يؤخذ عليهم ميثاق الكتاب ألا يقولوا على الله إلا الحق ودرسوا ما فيه والدار الآخرة خير للذين يتقون أفلا يعقلون والدار الآخرة خير للذين يتقون أفلا تعقلون. وقال تعالى الله أوصو السي سبحانه وتعالى فإذا قضيتم مناسككم فاذكروا الله كذكركم آباءكم أو أشد ذكرا فمن الناس من يقول ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة ربنا آتنا في الدنيا وما له في الآخرة من خلاق. Allah says, من كان يريد العاجلة, anyone who wants to attain and gain the hasty world. Allah says, عجلنا له, we will hasten for them. ما نشاء, that which we wish. لمن نريد, for whoever we will. ثم, and after that, جعلنا, we have made. لَهُ, for that individual, جَهَنَّمَ, the hellfire, يَصْلَاهَا مَذْمُومًا مَدْحُورًا, in which he will stay in it, belittled, and he'll be dwelling in it. Allah also says, subhanahu wa ta'ala, فَخَلَفَ مِنْ بَعْدِهِمْ, after them came a people, وَرِثُوا الْكِتَابَ, they inherited the book, يَأْخُذُونَ عَرَضَ هَذَا الْأَدْنَى, but they come and they take worldly gain from it. They inherited the book. Allah gave them the book. يَأْخُذُونَ عَرَضَ هَذَا الْأَدْنَى. They are taking dunya and money for it. وَيَقُولُونَ سَيُغْفَرُ لَنَا. And they say that we will be forgiven. وَإِنْ يَأْتِهِمْ عَرَضٌ مِثْلُهُ يَأْخُذُهُ. But if another worldly gain like that comes to them, they take it. So their whole purpose is dunya and money. What can I make from the deen? Allah also says, subhanahu wa ta'ala, فَإِذَا قَضَيْتُمْ مَنَاسِكَكُمْ, if you finish your manasik of Hajj, فَذْكُرُوا اللَّهَ, exalt Allah and remember Him, كَذِكِرِكُمْ آبَاءَكُمْ, the way you remember your fathers, أَوْ أَشَدَّ ذِكْرًا, or even more. فَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَنْ يَقُولُ رَبَّنَا آتِنَا فِي الدُّنْيَا وَمَا لَهُ فِي الْآخِرَةِ مِنْ خَلَاقٍ. From the people are those who say, oh Allah, give us this dunya, and they have no need, then they don't want the akhirah. All they want is the dunya. Oh Allah, give me the dunya. Oh Allah, do this for me. That's all it is for them. The Messenger عليه الصلاة والسلام, he said, تعيس عبد الدينار وعبد الدرهم وعبد الخميصة إن أعطي رضي وإن لم يعطى سخط تعيس وانتكس وإذا شيك فلنتقش أما فلنتقش. Both ways you can say it. أخرجه البخاري. تعيس means, تعيس actually means humiliated, is the Abdul Dinar, and the Abdul Dirham, and the Abdul Khamisa. A person who truly just wants money. He worships money, he worships Dirham and Dirahim. In U'tiya Radi, if somebody gives him money, he's happy, he's pleased that day. Wa'ilam Yu'ta, if he's not given that, Sakhit, he shows hate and enmity. That's the type of person he is. His happiness and his anger is actually connected to what? It's connected to the Dirham and the Dinar. That's what he lives for. That's what everything in life means to him. ولذلك شيخ الإسلام ابن تيمية said in his كتاب منهاج السنة النبوية فصاحب البدعة, the person of innovation, يبقى صاحب هوى, he will always remain as a person of desires, يعمل لهواه, all he works for and all he does and whatever he does, he only does it for his desires, لا ديانة, and he doesn't do it for religious reasons. A person of innovation. Dunya, dunya only. وَيَزْدُرُ عَنِ الْحَقِّ, and he will turn away from the truth. الَّذِي يُخَالِفُ هَوَاهُ, that opposes his desires. He will turn away from that truth. فَهَذَا يُعَاقِبُهُ اللَّهُ عَلَى هَوَاهُ, Allah will punish him, but Allah will punish him with what? His desires. His desires actually adab for him. That's his adab. وَمِثْلُ هَذَا يَسْتَحِقُ الْعُقُوبَةَ فِي الدُّنْيَا وَالْآخِرَةِ, and a person like that, he deserves punishment in this world and in the hereafter. وَمَنْ فَسَّقَ مِنَ السَّلَفِ الْخَوَارِجَ, and the Salaf who labeled the Khawarij as fussaq, transgressors and criminals. And like that, the reason was what? As Al-Imam, كَمَا رَوَى عَنْ سَعِيدٍ بْنَ أَبِي وَقَاسٍ أَنَّهُ تَأَوَّلَ فِيهِمْ, as Sa'id ibn Abi Waqas, he placed a verse on them. This verse he applied on the Khawarij, which is what? وَمَا يُضِلُّ بِهِ إِلَّا الْفَاسِقِينَ الَّذِينَ يَنْقُضُونَ أَهْدَ اللَّهِ مِنْ بَعْدِ مِيثَاقِهِ وَيَقَطَعُونَ مَا أَمَرَ اللَّهُ بِهِ أَنْ يُوصَلْ وَيَقَطَعُونَ مَا أَمَرَ اللَّهُ بِهِ أَنْ يُوصَلَ وَيُفْسِدُونَ فِي الْأَرْضِ أُولَئِكَ هُمُ الْخَاسِرُونَ. Allah says, وَمَا يُضِلُّ بِهِ إِلَّا الْفَاسِقِينَ, no one else becomes misguided except the fasiq. He would apply that on the khawarij. الَّذِينَ, those khawarij. يَنْقُضُونَ, they break أَهْدَ اللَّهِ, the covenant of Allah. مِنْ بَعْدِ مِيثَاقِ, after they made the promise with Allah. وَيَقْطَعُونَ مَا أَمَرَ اللَّهُ بِهِ, and they also disconnect that which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told them to bring together. Wallahi, if you ponder on this verse, they break apart and separate the commands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Today, if the government told you, you have to bring these documents in tomorrow, all of them you will gather them, and all of them you will bring them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's command, you don't bring them in its totality. You partially bring what you want, and you leave off what you want. وَيَقْطَعُونَ, they break off. مَا أَمَرَ اللَّهُ بِهِ أَنْ يُوصَلْ وَيُفْسِدُونَ فِي الْأَرْضِ, they bring corruption on this earth. أُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْخَاسِرُونَ, those are the destroyed ones. So from this, Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah shows that Ahlul Bid'ah, the people of innovations, always remain as people of desires, meaning they only follow their dunya desires. The people are four types. The people are categorized when it comes to the affairs of wanting the akhirah and the dunya. They are four types. A people who love to be supreme and high and have a status. يُرِيدُونَ الْعُلُوَ عَلَى النَّاسِ, they want to be high and above the rest of the people. And they want الْفَسَادَ فِي الْأَرْضِ, they want to bring corruption to this earth. And the corruption here is what? It is مَعْصِيَةُ اللَّهِ, the disobedience of Allah. And the likes of this is Fir'aun and those who follow him in his footsteps. إن فرعون علا في الأرض وجعل أهلها شيعا يستضعف طائفة منهم يذبح أبناءهم ويستحيي نساءهم إنه كان من المفسدين. فرعون علا في الأرض. فرعون wanted to be high on this earth. He wanted to be above the people. You see, that's what he wanted. وجعل أهلها شيعا يستضعف طائفة منهم يذبح أبناءهم ويستحيي نساءهم. He divided the people. And what did he do? He then weakened some of them. He abused them, subjugated them, and he slaughtered others. He killed the others, and he permitted for himself their women and committed zina with them, and also enslaved them as well. Inna kana min al-mufsidin. Verily, Fir'aun was from those who were the corrupt ones. Fir'aun was from the corrupt ones. So that's the first type of people. And people who have arrogance. They look higher than themselves. They want ulu on this earth. ولذلك الإمام مسلم narrated in his Sahih من حديث عبد الله بن مسعود رضي الله تعالى عنه قال قال رسول الله that the messenger said لا يدخل الجنة من في قلبه مثقال ذرة من كبر. He will not enter Jannah anyone who has a mustard seed of arrogance in his heart. ولا يدخل النار من كان في قلبه مثقال ذرة من إيمان. And he will not enter the hellfire the person who has a mustard seed of faith and belief in their heart. فقال رجل يا رسول الله. A man said to the Prophet of Allah, إني أحب أن يكون ثوبي حسنا ونعلي حسنا أفمن الكبر ذاك. A man said, O Messenger of Allah, I like my garments to look beautiful. I like my shoes to be very nice. Is that arrogance? The Messenger said to him, إن الله جميل يحب الجمال. Allah is beautiful and Allah loves beauty. الكبر, arrogance, is بطر الحق, the rejection of the truth. وغمط الناس, and looking down at people and belittling them. So the Prophet defined what arrogance is. Arrogance is batarul haq. Is when a person rejects the truth, he's arrogant. And then he belittles others. And that's a person who wants to be supreme, wants to be high on this earth. He wants to be the top one, the big boy. That's what he wants. The second type of people are those الَّذِينَ يُرِيدُونَ الْفَسَادِ. A people want to bring about corruption, but بِلَعُلُوِّنْ, they don't want to be high. Like those who steal. Those who steal, they just want money. They're not necessarily looking for superiority. They don't want to be high or anything like that. They just want money. The third type of people are those, they want supreme, they want to be high, but they don't want to bring about corruption. And these are the people who somehow, they've got religion, meaning they've got the deen. You see, but they want to be higher than everyone else. They want to be what? They want to be higher than the rest of the people. They don't want to be in corruption, they just want to be high. The fourth type of people are who? Ahlul Jannah. The people of Jannah. They don't want ulu on this earth. And they don't want to bring corruption on this earth. They don't want to be high and this station and rank. No, they don't want that. Nor do they want to bring about corruption onto this earth. Even that though Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has already, in the eyes of Allah, they're higher. Because they're the people of Jannah. They're righteous people. But in the eyes of Allah, they are high. But they don't look for that. That's what Allah said about them. وَلَا تَهِنُوا وَلَا تَحْزَنُوا وَأَنْتُمُ الْأَعْلَوْنَ إِن كُنتُم مُؤْمِنِينَ. You are supreme. You are high. If you're believers. You have iman, you're high. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he also said to them, فَلَا تَهِنُوا وَتَدْعُوا إِلَى السَّلْمِ وَأَنْتُمُ الْأَعْلَوْنَ وَاللَّهُ مَعَكُمْ وَلَنْ يَتِرَكُمْ أَعْمَالَكُمْ. Allah says to them, وَأَنْتُمُ الْأَعْلَوْنَ, and you are high. Don't worry. Have fear of them in any way, form or shape. You are high and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is with you. So na'am, those are the type of people. And this is what the ayah that we mentioned before, the ayah that we always mention, which is تِلْكَ الدَّارُ الْآخِرَةِ نَجْعَلُهَا لِلَّذِينَ لَا يُرِيدُونَ عُلُوًا فِي الْأَرْضِ وَلَا فَسَادًا وَالْعَاقِبَةُ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ. That's how the people are in regards to that verse. That the akhirah is for who? نجعلها. Allah said, we made the akhirah for who? لِلَّذِينَ لَا يُرِيدُونَ عُلُوًّا, the ones who don't want to be high on this earth. وَلَا فَسَادًا, and they don't want corruption on this earth. وَالْعَاقِبَةِ, and the final abode is for who? Is for the pious ones. ولذلك الإمام أحمد narrated in his Musnad, and الإمام الترمذي narrated in his Sunan, that the Messenger عليه الصلاة والسلام, السلام عليكم, the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said on the hadith of كعب بن مالك, ما ذئبان جائعان أرسلا في زريعة أما في زريبة غنم بأفسد لها من حرص المرء على المال وشرف لدينه. The Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, he mentioned two wolves. Are you with me, brothers? Two what? Wolves. Those two wolves were released. They were released. And when they were released, they got released in a herd of sheep. These wolves were kept hungry for days and they were released. What would they do? It will eat a leg of this one, it will eat the stomach of this one, it will eat the face of this one, it will eat just about, it will touch on every goat in that herd because of the hunger of the animal. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, the way that a person looks for money and is running after honor and fame is greater, the way he eats into his religion is greater than that wolf that is released into the herd of the sheep. The way that this fame and also money, the way it can destroy your religion, it can eat onto your religion like that, is greater, much greater than what? Then what do you call it? Those two wolves, what they can do to a herd of sheep or a goat. So, an Imam Ibn Rajab al Hanbali, because of this hadith alone, he wrote a book on it. Ibn Rajab, sharh hadith, ma dhibani ja'i'ani ursila. He wrote a very, mashallah, very little risala on it. And I advise you guys to try to read it. So, Ahlul Sunnati wal Jama'ah, their methodology and their way is that they don't allow anyone to try to attain through the religion and to use the religion as a stepping stone to attain a worldly gain. ولذلك Allah told us in the Quran, subhanahu wa ta'ala, an example of a man who tried to do that. He tried to use his religious knowledge. He tried to use his religion towards the dunya. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said about him, وَاتْلُ عَلَيْهِمْ نَبَأَ الَّذِي آتَيْنَاهُ آيَاتِنَا فَانْسَلَخَ مِنْهَا فَأَتْبَعَهُ الشَّيْطَانُ فَكَانَ مِنَ الْغَاوِينَ وَلَوْ شِئْنَا لَرَفَعْنَاهُ بِهَا وَلَكِنَّهُ أَخْلَدَ إِلَى الْأَرْضِ وَاتَّبَعَ هَوَاهُ فمثله كمثل الكلب إن تحمل عليه يلهث أو تتركه يلهث. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, وَاتْلُ عَلَيْهِمْ, read on them, Muhammad. نَبَأَ الَّذِي, the story of the one. آتَيْنَاهُ, we gave to him. آيَاتِنَا, our verses. فَانْسَلَخَ مِنْهَا, and he came out of it, he went out of it. فَأَتْبَعَهُ الشَّيْطَانُ, then shaytan followed him. فَكَانَ مِنَ الْغَاوِينَ, and he became from the destroyed ones. وَلَوْ شِئْنَا, Allah says, if we willed, لَرَفَعْنَاهُ, we would have lifted him high ranks. بِهَا وَلَكِنَّهُ أَخْلَدَ إِلَى الْأَرْضِ, but this individual, he scooped low. وَاتَّبَعَ هَوَاهُ, the reason is because he followed his desires. فَمَثَلُهُ, his example is, كَمَثَلِ الْكَلْبِ, the example of a dog. إِن تَحْمِلْ عَلَيْهِ يَلْهَثِ, if you give to that dog, his tongue will still be out. And if you don't, and you hold from him, his tongue will still be out. Nothing changes the dog. You can give the dog so much water if you want. You can give the dog so much food. His tongue is still going to be out, and he's just drooling all over the place. In other words, this man, revelation was given to him, he's still the same. Now it's gone, he's still the same. It has not changed him in any way, form, or shape. So this ayah rebuked this individual. And it has done it from many different ways. The first way is أَنَّهُ ضَلَّ بَعْدَ الْعِلْمِ, this man became misguided after knowledge came to him. And he had chosen disbelief over Iman deliberately, not out of ignorance. Also, he departed from Iman, a departure in which he's never going to come back to faith again. Number three, Shaytan followed this man. Shaytan had followed him and reached him and took him further away from the truth and where it lies. Number four, he became misguided after guidance came to him. Number five, Allah did not wish subhanahu wa ta'ala to raise him with knowledge. Rather, it was proof that was established against him. Number six, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us how low and pathetic his aspiration was. He only wanted something very low. He didn't have high aspiration. Number seven, the reason why he chose the lesser of the two, which is the pathetic path, and that he chose the evil way, is because of dunya. وَلَكِنَّهُ أَخْلَدَ إِلَى الْأَرْضِ. It was a person who had passion and desire for the dunya, and that's what meant something to him. Number eight, he gave precedence to what? Misguidance over guidance. He gave passion to desires over guidance. And he made his desires his imam, his shaykh that he follows. Number nine, he was resembled to be like a dog, which is the lowest of animals. The dog has the lowest aspiration when it comes to the animals, if you look at them. And he is the one who does the most filthiest things. So this individual was called and referred to like a dog. And number 10, he's also the way that the dog brings his tongue out. That's the worst situation of the dog. He's being resembled to that particular situation. Al-Qa'ida to Thalathun. The 30th Qa'ida. يعتقدون أهل السنة والجماعة believe وجوب, that it's obligatory, لزوم المنهاج النبوي. The أهل السنة والجماعة, they believe that it's obligatory to hold on to the prophetic methodology في الدعوة إلى الله, when calling to Allah. أهل السنة والجماعة, from their belief is that they believe that it's obligatory, wujub, that it's obligatory to hold on to the prophetic methodology when you're giving da'wah. قال تعالى, Allah says in the Quran, اتبعوا ما أنزل إليكم من ربكم ولا تتبعوا من دونه أولياء قليلا ما تذكرون. وقال تعالى, Allah says, أَفَمَنْ كَانَ عَلَى بَيِّنَةٍ مِّنْ رَبِّهِ كَمَنْ زُيِّنَ لَهُ سُوءُ عَمَلِهِ وَاتَّبَعُوا أَهْوَاءَهُمْ. وقال تعالى, الله also says, قُلْ هَذِهِ سَبِيلِي أَدْعُو إِلَى اللَّهِ عَلَى بَصِيرَةٍ أَنَا وَمَنِ اتَّبَعَنِي وَسُبْحَانَ اللَّهِ وَمَا أَنَا مِنَ الْمُشْرِكِينَ. وقال تعالى, الله also says, قل إن ضللت فإنما أضل على نفسي وإن اهتديت فبما يوحى إلى وإن اهتديت فبما يوحي إلي ربي إنه سميع قريب. قل إن ضللت فإنما أضل على نفسي وإن اهتديت فبما يوحي إلي ربي إنه سميع قريب. وقال تعالى, وإذا تتلى عليهم آياتنا بينات قال الذين لا يرجون لقاء نأتي بقرآن غير هذا أو بدله قل ما يكون لي أن أبدله من تلقاء نفسي إن أتبع إلا إن أتبع إلا ما يوحى إلي إني أخاف إن عصيت ربي عذاب يوم عظيم. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also says, فَلَعَلَّكَ تَارِكُمْ بَعْضَ مَا يُوحَى إِلَيْكَ وَضَائِقٌ بِهِ صَدْرُكَ أَنْ يَقُولُوا لَوْلَا نُزِّلَ عَلَيْكَ كَنْزٌ أَوْ جَاءَ مَعَهُ مَلَكٌ إِنَّمَا أَنْتَ نَذِيرٌ وَاللَّهُ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ وَكِيلٌ. And Allah says, قُلْ لَا أَقُولُ لَكُمْ عِنْدِي خَزَائِنُ اللَّهِ وَلَا أَعْلَمُ الْغَيْبَ وَلَا أَقُولُ لَكُمْ إِنِّي مَلَكٌ إِنْ أَتَّبِعُ إِلَّا مَا يُوحَى إِلَيَّ قُلْ هَلْ يَسْتَوِي الْأَعْمَى وَالْبَصِيرُ أَفَلَا تَتَفَكَّرُونَ.